Alright guys, well it's been quite a while since I've actually done a tutorial and I'm back on the hype map, Skyrim mappy thingamajiggy building town villagey things, and the piece of feedback I received was that these houses are too big, so I thought, hey, let's build a little house here. And so this is going to be a tutorial for this house right in front of me now, which is quite small, quite versatile, and it's less about the actual house itself and more about how you can piece together your own house in the same style. Now I haven't done this tutorial for ages, as I've said, so we're going to be kind of winging this, see how it goes. And I'm going to build it, I'm going to say put it, let's put it here. Okay, I think this should probably be a big enough plot. We'll see how this goes. So the way I usually do my tutorials is I will just stop talking when I'm doing things like this and then just clip and speed up the clips later, which is actually kind of relaxing, so I should be getting some more tutorials out soon, because it's something I can kind of just do without thinking about it. So because this house is, I'm going to call this house kind of like a modular house design, and that's a word that I'm using kind of loosely because I don't fully understand what it means, but it sounds like it should fit in. And basically you split the house up into segments, and you can do this on a grand scale or a small scale. We're going to be doing it on quite a small scale today. So a basic segment that I use when if I'm thinking about designing a new house design, pretty much every single one will have this modular design, and the modular design goes with a block of three, 3 by 3 by 3. And now when I say 3 by 3, I don't mean 1 2 3 1 2 3, I don't mean like that. I mean that is the gap in between the uprights. So all my houses are split up into uprights, gaps, which this is a 3, and then an upright. So now we can think about little designs within this module, and in this particular module what we have is a brick layer on the bottom. This does a good job at separating up the house, and then cobblestone on top of that. And now because this is quite a not particularly grand house design, we're only going to have small windows and they are going to be glass panes. Let me just grab my pane here. Doop, 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 doop. So this would be the first kind of module of the house. That is if I was just making a 3x3 house, which would obviously be way too small. So I'm going to get rid of this wall here and extend a module out another piece, which will come out to here. So you see we're adding another module on, and now we have two modules to the house. Now this will do on its own as a house design, but we're going to make it a little bit more interesting to keep in check with that house over there. And I'm going to turn this one slightly away, and the reason that in terms of town planning, I'm going to turn it away so the courtyard is here rather than close to the wall, because it will create a more of a sense of back alleys and things, because it will just be harder to get to. And the harder something is to get to, the more stuff is in the way of it, and the more stuff you see, then the bigger the build seems. And that's all about Minecraft. It's all about playing with a sense of scale, because recently quite a few games have been catching on to this kind of trend. If you've ever played Red Dead Redemption, you know that when you look across one of those huge valleys, which is you know, it's got those huge stacks of rock, you know, you're looking at it thinking, oh, this is far too big, you know, it's impossibly big, they can't have made a valley this big in the game, I'll never get to the other side. When actually what they've just done is taken a realistic landscape and just scaled it down, and it works perfectly. You're doing the same thing on Minecraft, because in real life having a 3 meter wide room, not so realistic. So the next thing we're going to do when we've got our base like this is start thinking about the next layer. Now you can see over there that the roof has got a kind of curved design, and it's obviously thatch. Now you don't have to use thatch, you can use wood if you like. I'm deliberately leaving wood out of this build so that you can use wood for the roof. I'm just going to be using thatch because I think it just looks a bit nicer. Now I've got obviously two thatch blocks here. If you're not using my thatch track then you won't have these. This is a cross thatch and a normal thatch. But first we need to actually design the top piece. So we're going to have a bar going across. This is going to mark off the bottom of the module. So we've got this 3x3 here. So just a nice shape, and also 3x3 with these two sections here almost makes the golden ratio, which looks really nice. Now to create the curve, we're going to have something that isn't 45 degrees. So if I was to have a roof going up like this, that would be a 45 degree roof. Too boring, not enough room on the upper levels. So we're going to go up two more blocks here, and one more block at each side. So now we've got this shape here, which I guess you're just going to have to copy. It kind of looks a bit like a Cyclops bunny. And then we're going to have one on top. Now, if I was going for a spiky roof, I'd have two on top. You can see how that would look. And you can do that, no problem. But I'm just going to stick with the one because I like the curve. So now we're going to look at our house as an overall shape and think about where else we can put this. And we're also going to go along the top of every single one of these walls with this wood. Now, something I've missed out on is a more dynamic roof shape. So you can see here on this house that this roof is one block lower than the main roof. And that is quite important. You can just have a normal roof going all the way around the outside, but there's something about it that doesn't quite look right. So what I'm going to be doing is taking off this layer of wood. I just lisped three times in a row there. That was quite impressive. And I'm going to bring up the roof just as it was, except one block lower. You can see how that the difference is only this crossbar here. Okay. Now, our entrance, I think I'm going to put my entrance here. And I'm just going to go up a block like that, and that will just make a nicer entrance. So we can test how this looks just by clearing away the door, and you can see how that looks like so. So when we've got pretty much all the roof ready, we can start thatching. And the way I do this is just going around all the edges. Now, on this end wall here, it's a little bit boring. We can make it a little bit more interesting. But first, we're going to just put our... So we've got what is called a dominant roof, or what I call a dominant roof. I'm saying all these words as if they're like scientific terms. It's just made up. So we've got a dominant roof here. This is the biggest roof, and this is the recessive roof. And the recessive roof always joins onto the dominant, and it's always lower. So the recessive roof never takes over the dominant. Now, the dominant should have two ends, and except in specific cases, the dominant roof should have this end and this one, whereas a recessive will usually only have one. By that I mean it's not going to carry on over here. See, if I carried on over here, look a little bit weird, so we're not going to do that. So let's bring across our roof here. Just go around on top of all the walls, and we can come down here to our recessive roof, go all the way around the outside like that. Now, I've missed out quite a key feature here. The top bits should be this cross thatch. Again, if you're not using my thatch, doesn't matter, ignore what I'm saying. Oops, there we go. And now we'll have the basic outline. Oops, I'm actually missing a layer here. That was a bit of a fail. There we go. And now we can start adding the capping off. So this is capping off the roof, just creating this overhang going all the way around the outside. Now, when you come to places like this, if you've laid out the wood already, then you should see where the natural curve of the roof goes. You don't even have to think about that. Now, if you're here, I'm not going to have an overhang because this is the recessive roof. So I'm just going to cap it off with parallel to the wall, flush to the wall. Now, sometimes this can look a little bit odd, but in some situations you can get away with it, and I think it works quite nicely here. Now, here's another little rule. If you're wondering whether you should put this block here or not, think about it like this. This is the dominant roof, so the dominant roof always has to be fully intact unless there are some special circumstances. This is not a special circumstance, so the roof should be intact and symmetrical on each side. Now, this big wall I'm doing right just then, that's going to have some more windows put into it, so we don't need to worry about that looking a bit bland for now. We can always make little changes later. Although, obviously, if you're doing this in non-creative mode and you've got limited resources, you're probably going to want to plan before you do all this. So now we're bringing up our recessive roof to the dominant roof. And we're just joining up. It should be quite self-explanatory, this piece. This bit, although I know that some people do have problems with it. Just go with what looks right. You can't miss it. Now, something that people tend to do with thatch roofs, they tend to make it look a bit more curved by doing this, and I've done this as well, so it's not like I'm taking the mic, but I would advise against doing that because if it was a proper roof, it would probably look good, but because it's not, because it is just made out of blocks, it doesn't quite look right. It kind of messes up the design. Now we're going to add in our little windows over here, so we're going to look at how it is. We can follow the modular rule, or we can break it. Now, if we break it, we have to make sure it's a symmetrical breaking, unless something suggests otherwise. For example, if this door here was on this side here, then we could have the big doorway and then we could have a little window. That's okay because there's a reason for this window to be bigger. But as it happens, there's nothing on this side that that suggests that this shouldn't be symmetrical, so we should make it symmetrical. Let's make it day, shall we? Okay. And to do this, I'm just going to add in a small little roof window like this. Probably a little bit too small. What I can do is raise it up. Trial and error, see how it looks. Clear off these two. Now we've got two kind of slitty windows. But I think they're a bit too big for the rest of the house, so I can block off the bottom. And if necessary, I can actually make this turn to a cross. I think I'll do the cross idea. There we go. Looks quite medieval-y. And we should be fine from over here. This side looks fine-ish. Yeah, we look okay. So, the next thing is this flush wall here looks a little bit weird, and that's normal. It's just simply because it is a flush wall. So there are a few steps that we can do. I'll do one step on one side and the other step on the other side. So one is overhangs. They look fantastic. I'm going to be using a wooden one. I used a stone one on the other house, but I'd like to mix it up a little bit so it's not all the same. Where is my wood? There it is. And I'm going to go, say half block overhang. Like so. Now you can put a full block there, or you can put in some stairs. I'm going to put in some stairs just to show you what it looks like. Stairs are a really, really nice tool, and especially when you can be able to put in upside down stairs, this is going to be amazing. But obviously the patch hasn't come out yet, side face. And we can add in that balcony here, and we can give it some bits like this, or we can take some fence, which I can take here. And we can do it with that. That makes it look a little bit more delicate and a little bit more fiddly, which is nice. Now, this bit, this is personal preference. Do you like having this little gap here or not? I personally like it. I think it adds a lot of definition, and also it gives you a nice space to put a torch in. Now, what we can do on the other side, and I shouldn't have got rid of my step here, there we go, is we can use this technique here, which is one of my favourite techniques because it adds this lip here. It gives the roof an overhang and it creates this dark space where there's shadow without actually affecting the overall effect of the wall at all. And I really, really like that. It's something that you can use on pretty much all builds. Like here, looks a little bit weird. Not a problemo. Just make sure that you complete the overhang like that. Stick a window in it. There we go. See, it looks nice. We'll stick in the windows all the way around, I think. That and like that. Now the reason I've done these windows two blocks high is simply because if you put in one block like that, it looks a bit weird. It looks imbalanced because it just looks unnecessary. I can't really explain it. It just doesn't look right. So you've got to put the double window in there. And I'm going to go ahead and use the step technique here as well. Just makes everything look a little bit more interesting and fiddly. And fiddly is pretty much the most important thing. Now, floors. When you come inside, you're going to be pleasantly surprised by the amount of size that you've got within the house, unless you're one of those people that just builds as big as you can get. So you take a look around at how much space you've got, and you can decide. So, I can go for a three block high ceiling downstairs here, and that works nicely with the whole modular thing I was talking about. And the reason why is because we've got this two block high roof over here, so we can go all the way to the edge. However, because we've got this lower roof here, we have to go one block lower. So I can choose to either make all the floors the same height, which is fine, or I can make them different heights, which means that you can create some really nice shapes, and you can even leave this bit open so you can actually look up inside the building. Looking up inside the building is fine, except it creates some problems with stairs, but that's something I'm going to get around by adding in a bit of wood here like this, two bits of wood layer like that, to create an inside kind of barrier, and that way we can have a bedroom here with a ladder leading up here to another bedroom, and you can block that off with a window, or you could just simply block it off like that, which I think I would do. No, I won't. In fact, I might get rid of that altogether. I think I might put a fence across here. There we go. So this is going to be a study, and downstairs is going to be a bedroom. There we go, and we've got a nice space to look up into. Now, this inside interior design is going to be pretty inefficient. I'm going to bring that out a block. Because the staircase is going to take up a lot of room. So I'm going to do two things. First of all, I'm going to put the staircase here. Now, this is the smallest staircase that you can fit in. It might upset some people's OCD. I know it did mine at first, but I got over it because it's so useful. And it looks like this. And the reason it pisses people off is because you've got a step leading straight onto a step. So it functions absolutely fine. Oh, well, it would if there was a hole in the roof. Functions absolutely perfectly. But in terms of looks, a bit odd. So, oops, that's what people prefer, but obviously that takes up a lot more space. I'm going to stick with this one. And we're going to put another one there. So this is basically a C-shape. Now, to cover up how ugly this is, I'm going to stick in a kind of barrier going up like this, which should pretty much cover up everything except for that bit there, but that's okay, so you can block that up, and that then gives you the opportunity to make a tunnel leading down into your basement. Nice little divide staircase here, so you can come up to this layer. So obviously this is really badly designed because we've got like no room up here at all, but you can see how you could easily make this a full room. You could even have steps leading down here. Let's just put some stone ones there. There you go, and there you've got a full roof and you don't even need that over there. So you could have a staircase, a bedroom down here. Yeah, I think I'll leave it like this. Now, if you wanted to add an external staircase, hello, that's ugly. What has that done that for? Ugh. Yeah. Oh, God. How's this even happened? Whatever. If you want to add an external staircase on, you can use the modular design once again and say if I wanted to put the staircase here. I could add on another 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And fill this up. In fact, I will do this for this building. Here's a little thing. If you're building on a slope, if you've done this bottom layer here, just carry the bottom layer on down. That will look fine. Not a problem. 1, 2, 3. Now the staircase obviously has to go all the way up to the top layer, so it's going to have to be quite a high little piece, so it's probably going to be in line with the other roof. So we're going to give it this little overhang here, then we go up, and there we go. We can connect this up to the roof like, oops, not like that. There we go. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. All the way back. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. There we go. There we go. And there we go. Dun, dun. And we can carry on this bit here. Wow. I'm going all misclicky now. Shows I'm getting tired. That should be like that. That should be like that. That should be like that. Let's go to some of this. It's a bit ugly. Cool, so we go into our room now, and if I get rid of the staircase. And cover that all the way over. So we can have a kind of crafting room here. Let's give it a little bit of floor. So say this is a crafting room, we can then block that off. Not completely, obviously. And we can have a little bit of a hallway going through here. We can block this off here. Have another room going through here. Block, open up this room again. Have a bedroom here. We could even make this go down the block. Now, if you're going to make it go down the block, I recommend putting in a little skirting board. And then when you put in the floor, that should look quite nice. But another little... Well, let's have a look at both. So... Oh dear, that's ugly. There we go. So that floor looks okay. A little bit bare, but another nice little tip is you can make this a half-block floor only if the furniture that you're putting in here will actually allow having a half-block floor. So if you're going to want a piston table, you're definitely not going to want a half-block floor. But if you just want a nice little bed in the corner, absolutely not a problem, and I will just show you how you can do that. Just delete the two half blocks, stick a bed in it. There we go. Also make some nice low bedside cabinets like this chest here. Not chest, you know what I mean. So, yeah, that's another little way you can use layers. And we've got our modular bit here, which we can make into a really, really nice staircase. And it's really not at much cost, is it? You just add on another bit of the building to create this kind of more. Okay. So this kind of style of just adding bits on where you need them is what creates an overall really nice medieval theme to your builds. Let me just quickly show you how to make this staircase here. We're going to make it light. Let's have that spiral. And now the great thing about having a 3x3 staircase is that you can do the type of staircase that doesn't piss anybody off. Half block, full block, half block, full block, half block, full block, half block, full block, and you're there. So you can put in a wall here, which would be wood if I had any. And we can put in another bit of wall here. There we go, loads of little rooms. Again, modular, 3x3, 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 but a bit lower, and you can just fiddle up with stuff like that. Whew! Well, I've been talking for quite a lot longer than I was actually planning on. Thank you for watching. Let me know if you enjoyed this type of tutorial, or whether you'd like me to do the more regimented tutorial. I think this one's a lot more enjoyable, but it requires me to be quite inspired, whereas the other type of tutorial is kind of just like, put blocks here, speed a bit up. Put blocks here, speed it up, and when you've done that, put some blocks here. Whew. So let me know what you think. Please leave a rating. I'm going to try and put a custom thumbnail on this image. I'm actually going to take the screenshot right now. How's that? Yeah, that'll do. F2. Cool. So I'll see you guys next.